7:53, welcome back. Traffic looking good so far on this Wednesday morning. Nice looking day out there, too. We're back with Isabel and Buying Canadian First, and you've got a great product here called ICE.
This is an amazing product. ICE stands for In Case of Emergency. Mm-hmm. And the concept is very simple. If you get hurt, how do the authorities know who to call?
Right.
Right? If your children are on the bus, they're cycling, they're whatever.
Playing sports.
They don't have identification. And
no.
Even you and I, if you think about what's in your wallet, it's all about you.
Yeah.
Of course, it has to be about you. It's all about
Unless you've got someone else's wallet.
But there's no information about, you know, call this person if I'm in trouble.
No.
So the concept was started in England by a paramedic right after the 2005 bombings.
Oh, really?
In the London subway.
Right.
Because 75% of the victims had no information on them as to who to contact, next of kin or whatever. So it took an
Just
average of 6 hours.
Just their basic information, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you come to think of it.
Think about it.
Yeah.
It's not obvious.
No.
So it took an average of 6 hours to reach the family members of these victims. So
6 hours?
Yeah, so this paramedic said, you know what, we've got to change that. So the first idea was ice your phone. So in your phone, put in your contacts, put ice somebody's name. So in
right.
my case, I put ice husband.
Right.
Put your husband on ice. And basically all
Which I'm
it
sure
is,
you've done before.
More than once. Is you put his number.
Right.
Is you put his number. So
right.
you put a couple
Just
of numbers.
Just like that.
And the paramedics in this country,
they know about this?
Policemen, firemen, they know about this. So they know to look for it. Now, the problem is if your phone is destroyed or you have a password on it, what do you do?
Right.
So a company out of Ottawa, ICE, in case of emergency,
right.
Gwen Staltari, said, you know what, I'm going to take the concept a little further, and we're going to make a really simple physical ICE tag.
Yeah.
So she has created different sizes of tags for different purposes. So
right.
look at these ones.
Even on a hockey helmet.
Playing hockey, right? You're
yep.
at the park with your friends, you know, you fall down, whatever. It's there. It's on the bicycle helmet. It's on
the tag
your...
here.
Right?
Yeah,
Life preserver.
Your PFD.
If you're running at night, just a woman or a guy running at
well,
night,
think
you
about
have
that.
No idea.
If you're going out for a jog in the evening or even in the early morning, when you should be at home watching our program.
Of course.
You're not going to carry ID.
You're not. But look at this. You just put it through your lace.
That's brilliant.
There it is. It's not heavy. Here, for kids maybe, you know, they want something a little, you know, less obvious. It's a little Velcro bracelet.
Right.
Dog tag.
Yeah.
Wallet card. Just
Good
a
thing to have
card.
In your wallet.
So basically what
and
she does...
And you can get that personalized?
Yes. So what she does is you place an order on her website, and she has them personalized with two names and two numbers. So all of these different products can be done that way. Now, the beauty of a new product she's just launched now is these are like quick ice. So you do them yourself.
Right. You don't have to order them. You just get
exactly.
them and fill them out.
Exactly.
Like your luggage tags.
Like your luggage tags,
yeah.
school bags, whatever.
That
so,
makes a whole lot of sense.
I think it's a no-brainer. You know, it's a back-to-school thing. You have to let your kids
yeah.
go out
and
more.
You know what, Isabel? It's not just for kids.
I know. It's for adults, too.
Yeah.
Even think about, you know, elderly people with Alzheimer's, maybe. Maybe it's important to have a contact on them.
Exactly.
There's a lot of different uses for it, but to me, it's such a simple concept,
yeah.
and we should all have that.
You're right. If you go through your wallet or your purse, you're really not going to find information on who to get in touch
nope.
with in case of trouble.
Nope. And,
yeah.
and it's not something you think about, but
yeah.
once you're aware, you're like, I need some of that.
Yeah. It's a great idea, and an Ottawa company doing it. That's
an
fantastic.
An Ottawa company, even better, right?
Isabel.
A local initiative. Oh, and one last thing.
Yes.
Perfect item for school fundraisers. She has these products in the local Catholic school board.
Okay.
So as the kids go back to school, and, you know, they're always passing the things about buying chocolate and buy paper,
They've
you'll
got
be
these
able
for
to
sale?
Buy these, yeah,
I'd buy
as a fundraiser.
Excellent stuff. Isabel, thanks.
Thank
Buy
you
Canadian
so much.
First at the website. Just go to the website, right?
That's it. Everything is always on there.
Excellent. All right. It's 7:57 coming up on 7:58. We'll take a quick break. No emergencies here, but there are people who can identify us, thankfully. We'll be back with hour three after this.